Fall of 1974. Been in Nashville about a year or more. Poems in a sack, couldn't catch a break. My guitar looked like a busted orange crate. I'd bought it off a boy whose name was Billy Hobbs, who slept with a snake in the basement garage of a cold water flat on South Tate Street, where the rednecks mixed with the Gate City freaks, where the Carolina pines grow tall and endure, where the dogwood blooms, where the bright leaves cured. I looked Billy in the eye and said, "Man, you can have it." Left tobacco road behind, but I kept the habit. Soon wintertime came to the bar where I was sitting. Temperature dropped and the snow started spitting. The door flew open to Muhlenbrink's Tavern. Time stood still as my thoughts started gathering. She was tall and slender, looked friendly and polite. She took a seat beside me, much to my delight. Said, "My name is Zelia, some say I'm a ghost. I don't mean to intrude, and I don't mean to boast, but I hail from the northeast coast of Great Britain. I've come to Nashville to write the greatest song ever written." Then she gazed in my eyes, looked me up and down as the bartender splashed out a weak 7-inch crown. "So what about you?" she smiled while inquiring. I said, "I'm here to drink the greatest whiskey you're buying. If I gotta listen to all your lofty ambitions, I'd prefer to be drunk. Or did I fail to mention? I've got no desire to become rich or famous. I'm just here to compose a song to my changes." Well, she tossed back her hair like the diva she was, smiled one more time like a ghost always does, threw up her hands and said, "That's not enough. Our hearts will need more as the going gets rough. A song that will heal us, keep us inspired, make us sing when we're weary, make us dance when we're tired." Well, I looked back at her with a skeptical eye, said, "I'll think about it, but in the meantime, knock yourself out on this coast of Great Britain. You go ahead and write the greatest song ever written." A year or two passed, then another year flew. The first thing I knew, it'd been a decade or two. I'd see her around town, tease her like a friend. "You got that song finished? You got it in the can?" And she'd laugh at the memory, then shoot me a stare and say, "No, not quite yet, but I know it's out there." And her songs were beautiful. She wrote like a fiend. She was a writer's writer and a publisher's dream. Tune after tune, hit after hit, she got rich over time, if I'm forced to admit. Then one day, she quietly cashed out, left Nashville behind in a cloud of self-doubt. So one sunny afternoon in the middle of March, I stringing my guitar out on my front porch. As her words like a message automatically fed, I could hear her sweet voice ringing in my head. And it was then I realized, without ever quitting, just how I could write the greatest song ever written. So I took out my pen, be damned or be wrong, and wrote down the words to this very song. Then sure as I'm standing, or sure as I'm sitting, I titled it the greatest song ever written. Now some say I cheated, devised my own scheme, but I say I gave life to someone else's dream. And if a song gets recorded, by luck or by guts, she'll get the credit, but I'll get the bucks. And forever I'll be known, till the day that I'm gone, as the man who wrote the world's greatest song. So write it I did, Even though I didn't, still I managed to pen the greatest song ever written. Check the Library of Congress, go look it up. Read it and weep while I'm passing the cup. But to tell you the truth, with a wink and a smile, it's just a matter of time, it's just a matter of style.